Today let's talk about Musou Glory. Musou Glory is a mobile phone game. It's a 2017 RPG mobile game masterpiece by Unity 3D. Let's talk about the feature here. You can have a diamond VIP by using money, or you can upgrade it into permanent VIP. You can have pretty much great privilege. And second one, you can have XP pool, which is increasing regarding your level, and you can retrieve anything here, the mission that you have not completed in the previous days. And now this is the single dungeon that you can clear it very easily. Now I have a level 85, and actually there is a lot of ahead level until 135 if I'm not mistaken. And this dungeon is pretty much easy. It can give you items to increase your stats. It has around 8 of this kind of the single dungeon, and if you are a VIP, you can quick purge if you are a permanent VIP. Basically, this is the game with the supreme music effect, which give the players a swordsman. You can have the male character, you can have the female character, and we call it the swordsman world that is full of the Japanese aesthetic elements. And you can choose to have a piece, or you can attack any other players here. This is called the Evil Sanctuary dungeon, and this one is pretty much easy. What you can do is that if you upgrade to a permanent VIP, you will get a lot of items. You can purchase it easily, and you can get 3 times of the normal players or non-VIP players. So it's up to you. It's completely a free of choice. If you want to be a free to play players or free to pay players. Well, what I experienced in this game is it has extreme voice 3D sensory experience, and well, say no to low end quality, and also say goodbye to noisy sound effect. Musou Glory used the Unity 3D engine to create a beautiful fantasy dimension with tailor-made supreme class BGM that gives you stunning visual and sound experience. But I'm not gonna show you here. It has also the multi-dimension gameplay, which is the only one. 360 cultivating root, multi-dimensional growth, refusing to be replicated. Well, to be the only you. It has also the intense game war, rich cultivating system, hundreds of personalized fashions, absenteeism and spy identity challenge. Well, I think that the game revolution has broken through the traditional mobile game restriction, where you can build a complete and fast world view full of moving story. You can experience intense fun from different gameplays. Jetpool bat also, and Endless Trials, The Heaven Spirits, Crossover, Gold Ring, and other ultra action game of fighting sense in the game is going to give you a surf. Well, I think this is the most popular RPG mobile game in 2017, where you are the one who determine the story plot and create the skills. So after the Evolve Sanctuary, we get the XP Dungeon. The XP Dungeon actually increasing your to get you a lot of XP. It will be millions XP. I can get in one shot level 135, maybe around 20 million or 30 million something. And if we proceed to kill a level, you can have a lot of more XP, and you also will have a title. So title is very important thing here. It can give you, well, it's not much of the battle rating or stats. It may be around 6,000 stats, but it's still you will have to get everything you can from the stats, from the title stats. So your stat will increase. The XP Dungeon is actually pretty much hard when you go against higher enemy, because not only you run against them, but you also run against times. The third one is the EQPT Dungeon. It's actually the Equipment Dungeon. It's pretty much simple. There's actually some level that you can have this. Like the last one, I need to increase to level 85 so I can get equipment. So this actually pretty simple, and it's pretty easy. And now you can purge all, and then you can quick clip. I will have until level 95 to challenge this EQPT Dungeon again. And this is the endless trial. Endless trial will give you also the XP, and you will gain rune and items also. Currently I'm at level 74, and challenging level 75 you must have a great defense, because the last time I do it at level 84 and I still not able to kill this boss, and now I'm still not able, I think, because my defense is pretty much low. I can only get it to HP times 4. So well, let's just continue to other dungeon. So now this is the God Soul Space. I can quick purge. It gives you item also. Now currently I'm challenge level floor 6, that's 16. Actually they are pretty you don't have to get any great defense, but you really have to get any great attacks. And between you killing the enemies, and also you can try to look around, and you can also open emails here, and also the XP pool and other items to increase your stats at the moment. So while your character actually trying to kill enemies, you can just sit around and try to think the strategical thought about using other items. Yeah, see, I don't have enough attacks to kill all of them in time, so it's a fail. Now let's go to the VIP treasures. So you will have a lot of until 9. I don't know, because I'm only level VIP 4. But and this is actually easy, and you don't have to take any sweats to kill these treasures. Okay, I think that's it. Let's go back later. There's actually 4 pets, but I will give you another look at the PvP. It's basically simple arena, daily arena, that you need to increase your rank by challenging other players. And yes, I fail. And you can challenge until 10 times. So after 10 times, you have to stop challenging them. And also, if you want to, actually it's only limited until 6 time, and it will be a cooldown that you need to wait. And you can also challenge the top player here, but I think this is a bullshit thing because we will not able to challenge them with Hess. I mean, the difference me between the top player is 3 million CP. And here there's a lot of PvP arena. You can claim your rights here, I mean the rank, and also buy or purchase any items that related to the PvP arena. Now I will show you the multiplayer dungeon. You can actually have the normal multiplayer dungeon. This is the normal multiplayer dungeon, which you party up to 3 people, 3 players, and it will show you the rank also here, who is the top rank in killing this boss. Still, you can solo this one, but just do the AFK, do the auto, because it will make your normal daily dungeon faster, because you have to do it 50 times, and if you solo it, it will take a lot of times. And then the second one of the team dungeon is Guard Imperial. It's also the same. You can join other player, but sometimes it takes too long, so you can just quit the team and create your own team. But then waiting for them is pretty much not fun, so I usually solo up. But even if I solo up, I'm not able to finish the dungeons, because it takes until 50 wave. So me myself, I think I can only do until 8 wave. But if you are with top players, you're coming with your like 4 million K CP, you might win this until current wave 50. But it's going to waste, because the other player is the one who kill all these mobs, and you will not be able to stand a chance against these other mobs, and you will die easily. If you die, you can use the gold. The gold is actually the currency here to revive, or you can safely revive. Safely revive will make a lot of time. You can have 4 chance of revive gold, but for the reviving, a free reviving itself, it will goes from 5 seconds to until 30 seconds. So see, now I have to revive at 10 seconds. I just say that you just don't have to, you do not need to have the gold revive, unless you are at level 50 and you still have like 5, like 4 times recharge. Sorry, revive. So you can just use the gold revive to ensure that you then ensure your success in killing the 50 with. So I guess that's it. I'm not able to pass wave level 9 if I solo it. Now this is the event hall. You can have all the time for the events here, including the boss and also the CS Fairyland, which needs you to be level 85 to do the Fairyland. This is the arm treasures. You can do it daily. And if you have enough vouchers, it will guarantee you to make a roll until the end, so you will get full rewards. And once again, using gold to reset might not be the best. I don't know, it will need a lot of gold and it will need you to recharge a lot of money. And I don't suggest that. Just enjoy yourself in doing this game. Slowly you will make there, eventually. We all are. This is the store which you can have the pet purchase, and also you can top up daily. And also there's an event that can get you quite good items. And this is the benefits hall where you can have the daily check-in, online rewards, offline XP and everything. This is the boss, but it's not the time yet. So they have the event also, like the Lunar Bonanza. Well, it's lunar because I think the Chinese New Year is almost near. So this is the pet. You can register the pet to do the War Pets Super Pet Contest. And also I need you to tell you that you can change your image, your avatar there. Now this is my items that you can increase the, and you can advance the items. Make sure to draw the treasure daily because it gives you the kitty. And this is the pet. I only managed to have 2 pets under level 85. There's actually a black market which you can buy pets using the real gold or essence. Essence is hard to get, but real gold is depends on your preference to recharge and buy them. And this is the social. You can have a marriage here, which is the same as my Wartoon games. Back then it was great. I took a marriage to someone in Philippines, but now I lost contact to her. And in friend zone, you can send flowers and also check the mail, and recruit friend also, adding friends. Now in the clan, you can have the clan benefits. Depends on your position there. As a clan elder, elite, or any, or only members, and also you can have from the clan war. And you can increase skills and do the daily clan quests. And this is the nurtures. You can have the item from hatching. So I suggest you to upgrade the quality first and then go for the hatching. And this is actually the boss clan, which will goes on around 7 PM. No, it's not the time, so I'll just get out. And also we have the clan dungeon. If you succeeded, you will get the points until level 15 is 380 PTS. But beware, because there will be, you will face a lot, some of the one or two top players. And this is the weapon shift, it's only give you in the events, if there is an event. You can also have chakra is consists of items that you have from killing the enemies. And this is the artifact, it's basically the same as like the, you know, the scorpions in some of other games. By increasing it, of course it will increase your CP. You can also increase your skill here, ranging from hit, dodge, crit, and anything. And this is your equipments. What you can do is you can equip gem, you can combine gems and then equip them in the equipments. And this is the rune. The runes is actually increasing your attack, defense, HP. And the war source is actually for equipment that is not, that do not use. And the advance, basically advancing your equipment from yellow to red, which is the top of the legendary equipments. This is your fairy that accompany you. She has equipments also that you need to increase, and also the intelligence skill and also the physical skills. It will help you to enjoy gaming experience better. And this is the equipment. You actually have mounts. You can increase your arms, wings, and trump. Trump basically like your drones. The concept is the same as the fairy items. And this is your info. You can have all your achievement here, and also your title. This is a shop. You can use gold or bone gold and other item from PvP and also from the PvE dungeons. Other thing, you can have the clan quest and everything there.